Hello, this is Alex Gorzen from Liquid Web with our video on how to create a cron task in Ubuntu 16.04. Cron jobs are a great time-saving tool to help you execute repetitive tasks on a set schedule. They can be used for setting up backups, updating inventory, or run whatever other task or program you configure it for. In this video, I will walk through how to set up a cron and make a quick script to backup data. So first, log into Ubuntu 16 as the user you want the cron to run under. If you don't need any root access, then using the user with the proper permissions would be best. I'm under my LW test user. The next step would be to make sure your system is up to date, so I'll run sudo apt-get update. Then, sudo apt-get upgrade. Just to make sure everything I'm running is properly updated so I don't get any surprises later. Next, we can quickly check to make sure the cron package is installed with dpkg-l cron. So I see it listed here, which should be the case with most systems. If it's not installed, you can install it with sudo apt-get install cron. I have it installed, so that didn't do anything. So next, I'll check to ensure the cron service is running using systemctl status cron. Here, it shows my service is inactive. This is because I stopped it a few seconds ago. To start it up, run sudo systemctl start cron. Then, checking the service again, it now shows that it's active, so the crons will run on schedule. To set up a cron, make sure the user you are logged in as can perform all the actions you need, as the cron will only have the same access and permissions as that user. There are multiple ways to add crons, but a quick and easy way is to use crontab. So if I run crontab-e, it first asks which text editor I would like to use. Use what you are familiar with, but I'm familiar with Vim, so I'll type 3 and press enter. Now in this file, it shows some information on how to set up a cron. All these lines are comments, since they start with the number sign. To keep things clean, I'll press the down key to go to the bottom of the file, and then press O to add a new line and enter insert mode, where I can start typing. I'll start with a quick example here and then explain what it means. 0, 4, asterisk, 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 slash bin, slash sh, space, slash scripts, slash backup-script.sh. So it might look confusing at first, but let me help break it down so it's easier to understand. The line starts with the schedule for when the cron will be run. First comes the minute the cron would run at, then the hour of the day of the months it runs, then the day of the week, then finally after that would be the actual command you want to run. My example starts with a 0, so that means it will run at the start of the hour. And since there's a 4 in the next column, it would only run at 4 a.m. Since the next 3 are all asterisks, that means it will run every day of the month, every month of the year, and every day of the week. You can put multiple numbers in a column separated by a comma to have it run at any of those instances. Like if I change 4 to 4, 5, 20, then it will run at 4 a.m., 5 a.m., and 8 p.m. If I wanted it to run every 2 hours, I can change the hour column to asterisk slash 2, so it would run at midnight, 2 a.m., 4 a.m., 6 a.m., and so on all day long every day. So, depending on your needs, this can offer a lot of flexibility in when the server runs a command. I'll change it one more time so it runs every 5 minutes, just so we don't have to wait long when it's being tested. Now I press escape, colon, W, Q, then press enter to save the cron tab and exit Vim. I set up the cron, but it won't actually do anything unless the command I run actually works. I'll create a simple bash script in the scripts backup-script.sh file that the cron is calling. This will copy the files from var www.html and zip them up into a file in the slash backup directory named lwtest_backup.zip. This is just a quick and easy example which will overwrite the same file each time it runs, but whatever code you add there, it will try to run it. Now I'll save and back out of this file, and to make the script actually run, I have to give it execute permissions with chmod plus x slash scripts slash backup-script.sh. Now I'll run the script manually to make sure it works. And I see the zip file is created. Now waiting for the cron to run and checking the file again after the next 5 minute point, I see the timestamp was updated without me having to manually run that backup command. I hope you enjoyed our video on creating cron jobs. For more how-tos and tutorials, visit our knowledge base at liquidweb.com/kb or our YouTube channel for more videos. Thank you for watching!